a good time. Put a smile on your face, yeah. KBKM and Elation Radio. Even brighten your day and help you through the night. Bring you good music. KBKM and Elation Radio. And here's your host.
Thank you for joining us on the Just For You podcast with Pastor Michelle Y. Wright. Listen, we are so excited to be back another week. God has found favor with each of us that are listening in on today. I want to say thank you, Lord, for all that you've done, all that you're going to do, and all that you have been doing for each and every one of us. I am excited because not only do we have our breath, not only are we able to listen in and to expound and praise the Lord, we are blessed. I need you to get that in your spirit. You are blessed on today, and no weapon formed against you shall prosper. I send greetings out to everyone, to our CEO and founder and all that she is, Dr. Kimmy Robinson. God bless you and our Elation family. I say we love you. I'm going to say it again. We love you, listeners, for taking time out every week to listen in to the Just For You podcast. We don't take it lightly. We recognize your time is valuable. You are valuable. God is good, and you didn't have to do it, but we thank God that you took time to be with us on today. We honor our husband, Pastor Donald Wright Jr., and we honor our guest of honor, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, our Abba Father who loves us ever so much. I am grateful on today that he gave us another opportunity to share his word. Listen, I want to not only thank you for listening in, thank you for sharing the podcast, thank you for your inboxes and emails. We're grateful. We don't take it for granted, and we love you. I would like you to know, if this is your first time listening in to the Just For You podcast, let me share with you what the Just For You podcast is all about. The Just For You podcast is designed to encourage, empower, and engage listeners to thrive spiritually and naturally, utilizing biblical principles. Just For You will reveal truths embedded in the Holy Bible to illustrate kingdom living, soul winning, compassion, and strategies to serve mankind, making a difference locally and globally. Just For You will allow listeners to hear teachings that are applicable, guests that will inspire, and opportunities for serving more effectively in the home, church, school, community, and marketplace. Listen, that is what Just For You is all about. On Elation Radio, we are grateful to be here each and every week that the Lord affords us. Well, listen, today's topic is a very good one. Amen. It is a topic I believe we all can identify with. I want to bring some clarity through the Word of God as we talk about where is your seed. Amen. Where is your seed? What are we talking about when we talk about a seed? A seed is your ability to sow for the kingdom of God. What does it look like to have a seed? Let us pray before we begin, because we need the Lord's guidance and wisdom as we move forward. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we ask that you come in, help us, lead us, guide us, direct us in all that needs to take place. You are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending. We trust you for every word. We trust you for understanding. We trust you to open up our minds, our hearts, and our spirits to receive what you want to say. We ask that you forgive us of our sins, and we forgive others that we may be forgiven. We are grateful for your presence. We are grateful that you would come and be with us. And we are abiding with you, Lord, and we say thank you. We ask that you bless our own Elation Radio with Dr. Kimmy Robinson, our visionary, our founder, our Elation Radio podcasters, and those associated with the radio station. Bless our families that are listening in. Bless our listeners, oh God. Bless today. Open us up. Give us some revelation on what you want to say concerning seeds and sowing, concerning your divine will for our lives, that we may clearly know what you are saying for your glory and for your honor. And teach us all how to be a blessing, not just to sow our seeds, but to be a blessing, to serve someone on today, to lift up someone in prayer, and to allow your perfect will to be done. We ask that you forgive us of our sins, and we forgive others that we may be forgiven. Have your divine will and way. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. So as we've talked today, we've talked about, we're going to be sharing on where is your seed, right? Where is your seed? For all of you gardeners out there, for those that have gardens, those that plant seeds, those that deal with plants, those that understand what it means to have a seed, to nourish it, and for it to grow, to produce, understand that you first have to start with something. That something you start with is a seed. The seed goes in the ground on good soil. You can't plant something on soil that isn't fertilized, or soil that won't nourish, soil that won't give life, soil that won't allow production to take place. So let's establish first, we need a seed. So when you're planting various things, you want to make sure the ground is right. Let's start there. Your foundation. You want to make sure that the ground is right. The type of soil, my God, you use is right. Because using the wrong soil on a certain seed could kill it. So we want to make sure our foundation is right. So oftentimes, if you're in gardening, you're going to research what type of soil you need, how it should cover your seed for the seed to take root to grow. Now, as it takes root, it's grabbing onto something to be able to hold up something, get this, under your foundation. I need you to understand that as something is growing, it is taking root, and the root has its nourishment from the soil. Then it begins to grow and to produce. It begins to give light. It then begins to have something on top of the soil, that there's evidence of something underneath the soil. Let me say that again. It will have something it produces on top of the soil to give evidence there is something underneath the soil. We're talking about your seed. What is your seed to the Lord? What is your foundation built upon? In order to stand on solid ground, we need it to be solid. In planting, you want to make sure it's leveled. You want to make sure your seed is covered. You want to make sure that seed takes root. Then you want to nourish your seed in order for it to grow. Today we're going to be talking from 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter. I want to share this with you because so often we hear people talking about sowing seeds. My question is, do you have any production or any production on your seed? Are you planting on good ground? Is what you're planting taking root? And if it's taking root, is it growing not only to produce, but is it growing to last for its purpose? So let's see what the Word of God says. We're in the book of 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter. For as touching the ministering to the saints, it is superfluous for me to write you. This is Paul talking. All right, let's go back to that big word, superfluous. What does it mean? Let me share the meaning. It means exceeding what is sufficient or necessary. And I like under the Merriam-Webster dictionary, it has in big bold letters, extra. It is extra for me to come to you. It is exceeding what is sufficient for me to write to you, all right? He's letting them know it is necessary, right? More than sufficient. More sufficient, amen, for us to hear that. For I know the forwardness of your mind, for which I boast of you. To them of Macedonia, that of Achaia, was ready a year ago, and your zeal have provoked very many. Let's stop right there. He's talking about the work of ministry. He's talking about cities that have learned how to produce. He's talking about building and storing and producing. And here he has favor with Macedonia and Achaia, for they were ready, the Bible says, a year ago, and their zeal. Have you been so excited about planting a seed that someone around you says, I want to have the godliness and the grace that I see because of the way you have a zeal? We're going to talk about that because what we find is when you talk about money, when you talk about seeds, people get confused. I've never seen such confusion. When you go to the store, you know, when you go to the register, you have to pull out your money to pay for your item. When you go and you have to pay a bill, you give them your credit card or your cash. You are clear that the objective is to pay the bill. I am also aware that whenever there's a need for you to be able to utilize cash, a card, or any other means of payment, it is never a misconception as to what you're doing. I often wonder, when it comes to the kingdom of God, why there is so much controversy about money in the kingdom. I'm really concerned as to where we're getting our information from. Because if we're trying to find an excuse, do we find those excuses everywhere we go? Do we find when we go to the gas pump, as high as gas is, that we're not going to pay that price because the gas is too high, so therefore we'll let our cars run on empty? No. Do you go to the gas pump with a card or go inside of the gas station to pay for your gas? Listen, here's the fact of the matter. When it comes to sowing, there is a spirit with it. One, we find time, there is zeal. There is zeal. Now, I don't know about you, but when someone tells me that they are a happy person, a joyous person, I don't have to ask them. There should be something present that shows me their zeal. All right? What is zeal? Zeal is eagerness and ardent interest in pursuit of something. Let me read it to you again. Eagerness and ardent interest in pursuit of something. So in order for us to have zeal, as the spirit of zeal is, with joy, with peace, with understanding, not concerning ourselves whether or not this is to be, but to understand the pursuit of something. 3, yet have I sent the brethren, lest our boasting of you should be in vain in this behalf, that as I said, ye may be ready. So what is he saying? I'm sending examples. I'm sending someone who knows the work. I'm sending someone who has production. I'm sending someone who understands that with the giving, with the sowing, there should be a spirit of zeal, which is your pursuit, ardent pursuit of something. It is you being ready, the Bible says, that ye may be ready. That ye may be ready. 4, lest happily, if they of Macedonia come with me and find you unprepared, that we say not, ye should be ashamed in this same confident boasting. Listen, there's nothing worse than being caught off guard. There is nothing worse than being caught and not having things done or not having things in place and not being able to fulfill that which was needed of you. Let's go to 5. The Bible then says, therefore, I thought it necessary to exhort. That means to allow you to feel the presence of God. Exhort the brethren that they would go before unto you and make up beforehand your bounty, whereof ye had noticed before, that the same might be ready as a matter of bounty and not as of covenants. Hold up. Wait a minute. What are you saying to me? That I must be ready when I sow my seed. I must have a heart of a pursuit of knowing that this seed is going to produce. I must do it as in overflowing in my spirit, in my heart, in my ability to understand. I can't be covetous. Sister so-and-so got $200. I may have 2. But my heart with my 2 ought to be just as blessed as the 200 that seems like it's in excess and abundance. I must understand I cannot look over at somebody else's seed and be covetous of them. Why? Because then I lose pursuit of something. Oh, my God. I'm losing pursuit of something. And that is the kingdom of God when we're talking about sowing seed. 6, but this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he that soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Simple. You're stingy, you get stingy back. If you're fulfilling and you're giving in and above with a joyful heart, whatever God has purposed, then you will be blessed in the same measure. We're not just talking finances. We are talking the ability to produce in the kingdom of God. We are talking about sowing that he gives his attention from us in the earth to be able to allow his anointing for us to produce any more or to produce even more. Listen, when I say that we have got this thing somewhat always wrong when it comes to the church, people see giving as financially only, not seeing that sowing is not only your finances, it's your time, it's your gifts. So we put more emphasis on the giving of the finances when we already know our time must be invested, our gifts must be invested. And if I give my gifts little, stingy, I should reap stingy and little. But if I give up myself to God and sow my time, my gifts, and my finances, I know that if I do that with the right heart, the right spirit, the right mind, then it's going to reap bountifully as I give it. The Bible is clear and says in 7, every man, according as he purposed in his heart, so let him give. Hold up. Wait a minute. As he purposed in his heart. As he purposed in his heart. How many of you come ready when it comes time to the kingdom of God to be purposed? The Bible first said, be ready. Now it's telling us to be purposed in our heart. Let's go back to zeal. Eagerness and ardent interest. Pursuit of something. I believe the reason why we can't grasp what this is saying is because we don't know what we are in pursuit of. It's our hunger and thirst for righteousness. Because if it is, we're going to follow what the gospel says and not put our own mentality on it when it comes to giving. We're not going to question, oh, they're just doing this with the man, he's doing that, because my Bible makes it clear and yours makes it clear that when we're giving on our foundation and we're planting our seed, that it's taking root in this gospel. I say that because the Bible tells us to be rooted and grounded in love. It teaches us to make sure that we're rooted and grounded. Being rooted and grounded with the foundation that we have, we will produce that which God has purposed. Let's go back to 7. Every man, according as he purposed in his heart, so let him give. Not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. What does that mean? I'm not going to say, I'm asked to do this, so I'm going to just give them what I want to give them because, listen, this is my time. After all, I'm not getting paid for it. And you know what? I'm not going to do that because, see, this preacher is going to be getting the money and they're going to do A, B, C, and D. There's no fruit. Then are we purposing in our heart? Are we purposing? Did we come with that? Did we say this is what it should be? Because you remember, there is life and death in the power of the tongue. What do you say over your seed? Do you command them to be blessed? Do you ask God to bless your seed? Do you ask him to bless what he's purposed in you to be able to produce? Do you ask him to bless your finances to not only build the kingdom of God, but be a blessing to your sisters and brothers in Christ? Do you ask him when it comes to your seed, whether or not your time can be blessed, because the more time you sow for the kingdom of God, the more bountiful you become. How do I know that? He says that we are to study to show ourselves approved, a workman that needeth not be ashamed. Are we seeking truth? Are we seeking his face? Are we asking him for wisdom? If you notice, before we come on to the Just For You podcast, we pray. Why? Because I have rendered all my service unto the Lord. I have recognized the seed that he's given me in my body, in my mouth, in my spirit, in my finances belong to him. It does not belong to me. Therefore, in order for it to grow, produce its purpose, it must be seeded on good ground. There should never be where you sow your seed on ground that is unfruitful. It will not yield you a harvest. It will not yield you any growth. It will not yield you any production. So will we go back to the word that says, as every man purposed in his heart? Why are you just giving your money and not asking God to bless your seed? Why are you giving your time and being grudging with it? Why are you living in a way that God says, wait a minute, did they get the scripture and 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter? Did they purpose in their heart what they're giving? Listen, I don't care who asked you for an offering. You better know what the gospel has said, what is purposed in your heart. Oh, I want to give you a line over here for $100. Did God tell you that? Oh, I want to give you a line over here for $1,000. Did God tell you that? Did you purpose that in your heart? Did you consult God? Did you speak over your seed? Did you ask him to bless it and to produce it if it's financial? Did you ask him to bless and produce the works of your hands for the giftings that he's given you, whether it's in ministry, in your business, in your family? Have you asked him to cover you by your obedience of the word? I'm going to tell you what I believe. I'm going to tell you what this gospel says, because it is true. You can't give and have a nasty heart and don't and tell God, well, it didn't work out for me, so I'm not giving back to you. God is the author and finisher of your faith. You don't hurt him or anybody else when you slack on your giving. You curse your house in Malachi is what it says. But thank God for Jesus coming, pleading the blood, taking the law off of us, that we can give freely as its purpose. This is what the gospel says in the New Testament, as its purpose in our hearts. Let me help you that tithe. Tithing is not just your finances. Tithing is your time, and the Bible says all of the substance of your house. Some of you just been given 10%. That is not what tithing is. You must give of all of the substance of your house. So in other words, if this is what true tithing looks like, when there is a necessity for food, it should be found in the house of God. When there is a necessity of funding, a necessity of gifts, when there is a necessity of these things, it should be found out of the substance of the house. This is why every pastor needs to know what they have up under their roof. This is what every pastor needs to know, who's connected to them. How do they fit into what God has spoken over the ministry? Are they there and they are serving, or are they just sitting? Are they being taught to be able to get what they have from God, utilizing for the house and outside the house that somebody else's life may be changed. Is there a zeal in the house? Is there a joy about what you're doing, what you're seeing? Are you excited? Or do somebody have to look for you to sow a seed? Does somebody have to say to you, hey, this is what is needed? Would you want to grow up in a house, and I'm going to talk a physical house, where you don't have any underwear, any clothes, any shoes, and you sitting there looking like, am I going to get some shoes today? Am I going to get some underwear today? Am I going to get some clothes today? Is that the way of the Lord, or is the necessities that are needed found in the house? Is it purpose in the heart that when it's given, it is abundant? Listen, I often talk about households with 15, 16 kids, and maybe it was just beans and cornbread, and maybe they didn't even know that they weren't eating something that other folks thought was poor. Listen, love on top of something makes the difference. Love on top of your giving makes a difference. Love on top of your sharing makes a difference. Love, love. Don't give to get back. Give that God can bless and produce you to keep on giving. I want to be a giver that he got to say, listen, you running low. Let me fill you back up. You are purposed in your heart. You are in pursuit, ardent pursuit of something, and it's bigger than your money. You find reasons and why it is to build the kingdom of God, not just talk about it. Not just talk about. This is why pastors got to inspect what they have connected to them. Why? Because if you're cursed in the mindset of not giving, you will bring that spirit into the atmosphere. And when people are building, just like Nehemiah, Nehemiah was a cupbearer to the king, and Nehemiah was trusted with building something. But here come the naysayers, here come the slackers, here come the people that don't want to build. They just want to distract, they just want to break, they just don't want to do their part, and then they want to find excuses. Listen, Nehemiah said, I'm going to stay focused. I'm not coming down off the wall. Hey, you know what, why you doing all that? It ain't even for you. It don't even belong to you. If you can't be a good steward, who are you? If you can't be a good steward, who are you? How is it that we have this mentality that we can go to the store, we can go to the gas station, we can go, and we have no problem? And even when you do have a problem, because maybe you're down sometimes at the gas station to your last. But can I say this? Has God being faithful? Even if you were in a mindset before today to understand that you need to purpose your seed, you need to purpose your heart to give, you need to give without being grudging, you need to give without being covetous, you need to be able to say, when you sow seed, to God be the glory. Why am I saying it? Because I've been living it. Why am I living it? Because the word says so. See, in order to be closer to him, you've got to know him. You got to sow your time in. And I'm not talking about just on a Sunday service, Sabbath, or any of those things. I'm talking about how much time do you have one-on-one with him? How much time do you sit at his feet and pray? How much time do you give him for what he's purposed in your heart? How much time? And then in your time, when you're blessed with your money that you steward over, how much of your stewardship give to the kingdom of God, not the people, as an appreciation of what he's given you for his glory? How many times do we sow our gifts? And our gifts are sown, and people say, oh, they're using you. Or you ain't getting paid for that. Or you not doing it. Listen, your gifts don't belong to you. They don't. But the word does say a servant is worthy of their hire. Listen, when there is confusion in the camp, it is not God. Whatever God does, he does it well. Whatever God deems necessary, he provides. I wouldn't go into ministry. I wouldn't do anything if I didn't believe that my daddy is far smarter than me. And he can provide much more than I can. The only thing he's requiring of me is to speak over my seed, purposes in my heart to produce for the kingdom of God. Can he trust you? Where is your seed? Where is your seed? Thing you told God, I'm giving to you. But give it to him. So, oh, I got this bill doing. He know my heart. I got this doing. And I'm going to do this. Why? Because he's watching over your seed. 8. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. As it is written, he hath dispersed abroad, he hath given to the poor, his righteousness remaineth forever. His righteousness remaineth forever. His righteousness remaineth forever. His righteousness, my God, remaineth forever. That's the gospel. That's the gospel. Did you notice he says in 9, as it is written, he has dispersed abroad, he hath given to the poor, his righteousness remaineth forever. Now he that ministereth seed to the sower, both minister bread, y'all better catch this, for your food, and multiply your seed sown, and increase the fruits of your righteousness, being enriched in everything to all, not some of your bountifulness, all bountifulness, which causes through us thanksgiving to God. What are you saying after you give your seed? Do you even have a seed? Because it should yield thanksgiving to God. Now, I'm not giving them that because that's too much for them and blah, blah. Sometimes God will say crazy stuff to me like, boom, here's a number, give this to so-and-so. Now, I don't have to know what that is for. I don't have to question, because I walked with him too long, why I need to do it. Because here's the fact that I know. I've got a seed that's in the ground that is multiplied and increased that I can become a giver. Listen, that is a blessing within itself. And then he says, not only give, but continue to give. I'm not giving to you to keep it to yourself. I'm not giving to you to just multiply to yourself. The Bible makes it clear. Let's go back to 10. Now he that ministereth seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food and multiply your seed sown and increase the fruits of your righteousness. Let's go down to 12. For the administration of this service not only supplies the want of the saints, not the need, catch on. It says, for the administration of this service not only supplieth the want of the saints, but is abundant also by many thanksgivings unto God. while by the experiment of this ministration, they glorify God for your professed subjection unto the gospel of Christ and for your liberal distribution unto them and unto all men. Listen, quit trying to keep things in your religious mind to just your church, just your little few. I dare you to venture out to make sure the house that you in, that you take care of it. Your house that you live in, you take care of it. Your neighbors, you take care of it. You see somebody in need and you got it, and you walk past them and drive past them, talk about God didn't tell me to give. I promise you one day you might be in them same shoes. And guess what? Somebody can do the exact same thing you did to them because your mind did not have a zeal. It did not seek and purpose God in your heart, because something about purposing in your heart will tell you where your seed needs to go, that it may be increased. What does that look like? If I give to someone in need and not knowingly what their need was, and God allowed them to ask him to meet a need, and here you or I come and we sow a seed, and that seed is exactly what they need, you know it's God. I hear it too often. Why? Because if I'm not listening to God, I'm just giving, and it doesn't mean he's going to produce it or multiply it. I need all my seeds to be multiplied and produced. I'm going to say it again. I need all of my seeds producing and multiplying. I don't need to just give them away. That's the gospel. Not just unto where we're serving, in my home, in the ministry, in the neighborhood, in the community, out of state, across the world, your seeds should be directed somewhere. And when you direct your seeds on fertile ground, is constantly producing. My husband and I started ministering when we became friends and grew into our relationship and then married and saw the production of seed. We learned firsthand about giving. And I'm not talking about when you think you got it. I'm talking about when you go through as well. You still owe God your thanksgiving. You still owe God to give, because he's given unto you. 14. And by their prayer for you, which long after for you, let me go back. I'm getting excited. And by their prayer for you, which long after you, for the exceeding grace of God in you. This ain't just about you giving some money just for a purpose. There's some things that should come to you, too. There's not one seed sold in this ministry that we don't pray over for God to produce it, that they have exceeding grace. This is the gospel. This is the gospel. This is what every pastor should be doing. Praying for exceeding grace in you. The grace of God in your life. That he says in 15, thanks be unto God for his unspeakable gift. I hope we're clear. I hope you understand your giving ain't just to your church or to your leaders or to whoever you're sowing your seed to, that it does not produce. I am scared of anything in anybody that can give a seed and nothing produces from it. It ain't scriptural. But when you sow your seed, I'm a witness. Lost our home, lost our flood, never skipped a beat. Stayed in 3 and 4 star hotels the whole time. Till he brought us back home and began to show us how to multiply that seed. See, somebody's not getting that when you sow your seed purposed in your heart, giving it unto God, giving up your talent, giving up your every gift you have, giving, that it will multiply and come back to you in the time of your necessity. That's why you can't afford to give with a nasty attitude. Because when you're in need, you're going to reap, the Bible says, what you sowed. I will never, ever worry a day in my life if God will ever take care of me. He can choose who he wants to do it, just as he chooses me to do it for others. I want to encourage you on today. Never give with a wrong heart. Never question the ability of who you're giving your seed to, because maybe you're the person that are. Because if your heart ain't right, it brings a spirit of confusion. And that's the opposite of what he said at the beginning of having a spirit of zeal. Give with the right spirit. Be cheerful. Don't release something to somebody and say, oh, I sure wish I shouldn't have gave them my last. You shouldn't have gave it at all. Not with that spirit, because that's what you're going to get back. But I dare you to say, make me a blessing. A blessing is your needs are met, and he blessing others. And even when your needs get low, if he ever dare you to say give, oh, you better give and give quickly, because he never tells you to plant a seed and not produce it or increase it. One last final point. It takes time sometimes for multiplication and production. When you plant a seed, it don't grow overnight. It takes time for it to develop and grow. And if you're faithful to your nourishing and you're watching and you're making sure that seed in the ground is properly taken care of, it's going to produce above the ground. Your life going to produce where others see it. Not because you're doing anything to produce yourself, but because the gospel takes care of its word. It takes care of its seed. That's why it's never a competition. Ever. It's always the abundance of the gospel, the grace of God that will produce and multiply. Have you ever been in a church where everybody running to give? They know the power of 2 Corinthians 9. Oh, they just crazy. They just crazy about their church. And if you say what you want to, I guarantee you their lives are blessed, because they never came without a spirit of zeal. I want to encourage you to pray about your seeds to your local assemblies. Make sure you give them with the right heart. I say to anybody that chooses to give to our, oh my God, to our ministry, please make sure you give with the right heart, because we pray over it. We don't let seeds come through and we don't pray over it. It's our duty to pray that God will bless and that he will cover and that he will multiply for you in your life, that he may get the glory with all thanksgiving unto him. Where is your seed? I pray this week's exhortation has been a blessing unto you, that it will continually help you to grow and develop, that you may give him all of the glory. I want you to know, if this is your birthday month, hallelujah, we made it to June, y'all. If this is your birthday month, we celebrate you. If you've graduated, happy graduation. We celebrate you. If you're getting married, gotten married, celebrating the anniversary, whatever it is that brings you joy. Here it just for you and Elation Radio. We're celebrating you. We're celebrating your accomplishments, goals, ministries, hearts, what you're doing that brings you joy. The exact opposite. Sometimes there's been sickness, death, things have happened and occurred. I want you to know we are praying for you. We don't just say it, we do it. At Elation Radio, we pray. We pray. Just for you, we definitely pray. We believe in the power of prayer, all of us, that God would hear and answer for your need. For him to answer your need. And for us to know his will concerning you. We want to send our condolences to Ruth Nichols, Ruth Latches and Nichols family, still to Orlando Watson's family, people endure, the Bell family, the Houston family, to the children's family of Uvalde, Texas, to the families of Buffalo, New York. We're still praying. Just because it's old news to the media don't mean your heart still isn't broken. We are still praying for you. To all those that have various things going on in continents of Africa, China, various components across the world, France, we're praying for you. And to all that are heavy laden, brokenhearted, and we just got through Memorial Day. Some people just buried loved ones. Some people have had loved ones gone a long time. We've had multiple military families that have experienced grief and loss. We're praying for you. We want you to not forget about. If you're in need and have needs, physical needs that you need, please keep your hearts and minds open to call in the St. Louis area, United Way. They will connect you with a resource and they will take information to help you towards your needs. Perhaps that you've called United Way, but you still may need some additional assistance, or you may want to try a different organization. We highly suggest Urban League St. Louis. That's Urban League St. Louis. To contact United Way in the St. Louis area, you dial 211. To contact Urban League St. Louis, you can reach them at ulstl.com. I want you to know, let God lead you, that he can bless you, that the seeds that are sown will be a blessing to your life, because you've sown seeds as well. I also want to share with you to keep your minds focused on the Lord. It's nothing like hearing a word and being obedient, because the Bible just talked about in 2 Corinthians 9 that their lives were subjected unto Christ. If you don't know the Lord, if you don't know him and you are not connected to him and you want to be saved, I want you to know now is a good time. Don't wait till next week. Don't wait till the next day. Give your life to the Lord. He tells us in Romans 10, 9, and 10 that we are to believe in our heart and to confess in our mouths that he is Lord and we shall be saved. Not only that, but then find a connecting ministry that you can sow your seed of yourself that you can be a blessing in the giving that you have, that the church would abound the more. It starts by you asking God for forgiveness of your sins. And as you ask him for forgiveness of your sins, you commit to the relationship, not just the church. You commit to praying and seeking the face of God and hearing from a preacher that is sent that your life can abound. We pray also that not only do you have these resources, but begin to pray for your neighbors, your children. Please cover your children as they go in and out. We all saw the heartbreak of knowing they all went to school, but some never came home. Some teachers, faculty, went in to go to work, but never came home. Let us learn to love and appreciate and to deal with the things that we have to deal with in our families and our home, that we can consistently grow and seek the face of God together. If you're saved, you should want your spouse to be saved. You should want your children to be saved, your neighbors to be saved, your other church members that are really walking on both sides of the fence to be saved. Not just you and your crew, but for everyone around you. As you are carrying this gospel, as you are sharing that he is Lord, we want others to know he is Lord as well. If you'd like to get in contact with us, here it just for you. You can reach me, Michelle Wright, Pastor Michelle Wright, under the name of Michelle Wright, that's M-I-C-H-E-L-E, Wright, W-R-I-G-H-T. On Instagram, it's HisBlessedGirl7. HisBlessedGirl7. You can send me your community announcements, your prayer requests, and we will pray for you. We are excited to serve and allow God to do his perfect will and work in your life. I want to encourage you, if you've been down, to know God is still good. I want to encourage you, if money has been low, that he is your supply. I want to encourage you that if you find there's no hope, he is your help. Never, ever dismiss how much he loves you, because he loves you with an unfailing love. His love never fails, even when people fail us. I want you to know your worst trial is his best opportunity for a miracle. Your worst trial is his best opportunity for a miracle. Let us pray out. Abba Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this time in your word. We thank you for Elation Radio. We thank you for the visionary, Dr. Kimmy Robinson, her family, the Elation family and their families, every listener and their families. We thank you, Lord, for being able to hear and to answer our prayers. We lift up leadership all over the world, asking that you put hearts that are like your heart inside of them, that they do what you need them to do and we need you to do according to your will for your people. We pray, oh God, that you will hear the hearts and cries of the brokenhearted, for every family experiencing loss, physically, emotionally, or by death, that you will heal, save, and deliver. For the loved ones we're praying for, family, and those friends, and those who don't know you, we ask that you save on today, oh God. Give them a peace in their soul of the safety they can have being with you. I pray, oh God, that you meet the needs of every person listening in and every person that is crying out for someone, that you hear their prayers. We're believing, oh God, for every seed that will be sown for the body of Christ, that you will expound and abound them even the more, that every seed sown with the spirit of zeal will produce and multiply in their lives. Because you are good and you are great. We pray that you make us a blessing, that you exceed our needs, that we will be able to have more than enough, or at any given time you command us to give, that we won't be selfish, hard-hearted, or grudging, that we will give because you've ordained us to, that you will be glorified and lifted up. We pray, O God, that your perfect will be done. Meet the needs and forgive us of our sins and give us a heart to forgive others. We all need you. There's no one under the sound of my voice that doesn't need you. We need you for one aspect or the other. And Lord, we pray for every enemy on assignment, that we send them back to the pits of hell from whence they come, and we lose the anointing of victory in the atmosphere, that which came to destroy destroys itself and goes back to the pits of hell from whence it comes. It has no authority or power over the people of God, and we thank you in advance, for we plead the blood of Jesus, that where the blood of Jesus is, the enemy cannot come nigh. And when we are baffled and when something comes up, that we remember to trust in the Lord with all our heart. Don't lean to our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge you, and you shall direct our path. We thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers. Oh, we ask you to have your divine will and way. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. We thank you so much for joining us and praying with us and studying with us. And we're looking forward to meeting you again if the Lord says the same. We're looking forward to every Wednesday being here with you at 5:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Mark your calendars. Listen, if you are not able to hear the live, please, you can go to most digital platforms to hear the replay for all of the podcasts that are on Elation Radio. You can find them on YouTube, Blog Talk Radio, Spotify, iHeart, to name a few. Please pray for everyone that is out doing the will of God. We need your prayers. Please keep us lifted before the Lord, that he may be glorified and that our lives will multiply in him. Not physical things, spiritual, as well as in our lives and purpose in him. The Bible says, seek ye first kingdom of God, St. Matthew 6:33, and his righteousness, then all these things will be added unto you. Remember, he's first. All things else will be added. We pray again that this has been a blessing for you. Thank you for listening again to the Just For You podcast. This has been your host, Pastor Michelle Y. Wright, and we thank you for taking time out of your schedule to listen in on today. Continue to lift us all up in prayer and know that we're praying for you. Until next time, God bless you, and we love you. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
shining. Folks are always smiling. Go play. Where crying is unheard of, and dying ain't even thought of. Oh, a place where there's no color skin, and you won't find no sin. Oh, a place. And I wanna get there. Yeah, I'm gonna get there one day. I wanna get there. I'm gonna get there one day. Wanna get there one day.